Hi, and welcome to Conversations with Des. I'm your host, Des Blanchfield. I've invited Kevin Jackson to join me for a conversation about healthcare, and particularly some of the latest trends and topics to do with health. Kevin, thanks for joining me. Great to see you.
No, it's great to catch up with you, Des. You know, this healthcare space is really changing dramatically.
Well, in fact, in Australia, because we've got such a vast, wide open space, we have a lot of challenges around this area. And in particular, telemedicine is an area mm-hmm. we've been looking to. I mean, with 5G, there's a whole bunch of things like language translators, particularly with video conferencing or not, where doctors and patients can talk over broadband and wireless. We're going to see a lot of network edge technology come into play here, given 5G has such a low latency, high throughput. In fact, 66% of practitioners around the world now are reported to be developing healthcare programs to leverage this type of technology.
Yeah, this is important because from the other side of the coin, remote patient monitoring leveraging 5G would be huge. It really enables better connections on mobile devices, and it helps the healthcare workers give improved live and real-time remote care. I mean, according to the AT&T white paper on healthcare, IoT devices can help the healthcare providers remotely monitor vitals and track medications, and really transfer current data quickly to staff so they can make more informed decisions faster. And wearables are really important in the healthcare marketplace as well. In fact, wearables can reduce hospital costs by 16% over the next few years.
That's a pretty significant win. A favorite of mine is augmented reality and virtual reality, and 5G with its high throughput connectivity data-wise and low latency makes things like virtual reality and particularly augmented reality mm-hmm. possible. And I think the potential would help and enable doctors, nurses, interns, et cetera, and staff all around healthcare to apply visualization technology, visualization procedures in engaging with, people in the hospitals and remotely, learning via remote learning by doing practicing and so forth. This is going to enhance everything from education through to practice. In fact, in the report, I think something like 55,000 people watched a virtual reality live stream recently of a cancer surgery, according to Medical Realities. Thinking about 55,000 people watching this remotely, just from an awareness point of view, makes me realize that if we were doing this as practitioners, mm-hmm. it's a significant game changer.
Well, it's like healthcare is becoming a sport for watching. But I know you're the data person, but with respect to data, 5G can really distribute that data to multiple points of care. And this enables innovations. You know, healthcare does have a supply chain, and by leveraging data, you can get remote diagnosis, remote surgeries, it improves hospitalization logistics, intervention planning, you can get more transparencies. All these things really improve patient engagement.
Indeed, and I think we're seeing now, especially with the rollout of, edge computing, edge networking, and so forth, decentralizing this whole model of healthcare by leveraging the likes of 5G. Mm-hmm. 5G is going to support this whole decentralized healthcare ecosystem in so many ways. We could spend a whole day talking about it. But like freestanding and satellite centers are now going to be able to interconnect and work together in a real time as opposed to sending things through couriers and help make hospital services more reliable and accessible for people. 5G has got the capacity to enhance not just live stream video and conferencing, but low latency movement of images and data and things in real time telematics, particularly with the likes of haptic feedback technology, and provide even faster remote access to things like electronic health records, improve online and live remote consultations, which I think is going to be a big thing, and enable more efficient data transfer for things like high res images of scans from one site to another. Mobile apps being used for different use cases we've seen, and I guess help support remote procedures and robotic surgeries in time.
Yeah, I think AT&T really did a great job in this study. One of the areas that kind of surprised me, but if you think about it, it makes sense. But they focused on large file transfers. 5G has the capacity to make these transfers faster. These huge medical images and exceptional network performance will give you better care, more efficient care, and hospitals can be able to see more patients in the same amount of time and at lower cost.
Indeed, and all of those are positives. Help people get healthier faster, reduce the time in hospitals and the risk associated with the costs, and I guess at the end of the day, improve life or potentially save lives.
Yeah, I mean, the future of healthcare with 5G is good for all of us as we get older, guys.
Speak for yourself, buddy. Well, thanks for catching up. It's been great to see you, and I guess, you know, we've talked about some of the key highlights that have come out of this report from AT&T focused on healthcare and where technology around this can help, and obviously AT&T business themselves.
Yeah.
We'll have information underneath this in the video description for people to go and read more on the AT&T business website, look at the health-related portal, and potentially download the report and hopefully engage online through digital and social media.
Excellent. So thanks a lot.
It's been great to see you, and look forward to chatting about another topic with you soon.
Absolutely.
Cheers, Kevin.